Drop me a line to your box. That's number one. My. We're taking the bag outloader. This is what a bag outloader looks like. So, you'll see. Taking the old 4640. We checked the coolant already. We've got a little bit of a leak, so put a little bit of water in that. Oil on the outside, always check the oil. And a little bit of hydraulic oil leak as well, so just put some hydraulic oil in and it goes in there. There's a dipstick. Well, we're gonna get going here. We are going to have a look at this. Love this big girl. Don't forget to lift her up. We're good to go now. So the last thing that you want to see when you pull up to a bag is a big hole in it. Especially when you've had a lot of rain in the last 2 weeks. I'm not sure how long that hole's been here, but I'd assume it would be longer than the last 2 weeks. Or it wouldn't have been, we had rain three days ago, so the chances are it's been there longer than that. So that means all that water's gone in there and it's gonna be wet down on the bottom. Because the water goes straight through the grain and it sits on the bottom of the bag, because obviously it can't escape out the bottom of the plastic unless there's holes in it, but even then it's still going to be wet. So sometimes some bags are good, they're completely dry. When you've been having a lot of rain and there's holes in them, they can be wet to here and then be dry, which I just say the case will be. I'd say we'll have a little bit of shoveling to do, maybe a lot of shoveling to do at the start, but then once we get past that, it'll be smooth sailing. And we have the bags facing downhill, so any water goes in, it's gonna run that way and not down back further into the grain. However, sometimes you just have a lot, like in a mouse plague, or you have a really bad ripped open bag in a lot of places and then get rain on it. It just has a layer of wet grain about that thick all the way along the bag. And you can either roll that up or you have to shovel the whole thing out. But when the bags are dry and good, they're really easy to handle and they unload well. But when they're wet, which we will find out if this one is wet soon enough, they can be a bit of a pain. chase bin down as well. We're gonna fill it up with the start. So if there's any wet stuff, it'll go into the chaser bin. Truck. We're just gonna load him because it's too wet right there next to the bag. It'll dry up by tomorrow, but we don't want to bog the truck. We're just filling with the chaser bin. Put 26.5 ton on, a couple of loads, we'll fill him. He can take 50 ton. Wait for him to go up and turn around. So he can go out the road. We're loading. Mark likes to stand up there. I suppose he gets a good view. We didn't have any trouble with wet stuff at the start, like I thought we might. Just That's the amount we had to shovel, which is really nothing. So that's exactly how we want every bag to be. No wet grain, just beautiful dry prime hard wheat. So yeah, top of the bag goes over, bottom of the bag goes underneath the interior. We have this heat cutter or hot wire that's connected to the battery that goes, that cuts the bag as it rolls along, so no one has to stand there with a knife and cut it or anything. The bag went over that and bent it at some point. And then yeah, the bag just rolls up like that, and at the end you've got a rolled up bag. You have to unroll it and cut it up and fold it up, or some people burn them, but that's not really good for the environment, I don't think. But you gotta do what you gotta do, I suppose. This is a bit of wet grain, so there's obviously some wet grain on this side underneath, and if that rolls up too much, you will actually rip the bag. Sometimes you can cut it and it'll fall out, but at the moment it's all right, but we'll see how we go. See, that just rolls in there, and that doesn't actually go in the auger, because it just, the cross auger skims across it, sticks to the bag, and that gets rolled up in there. So I just have to watch that. Sometimes it stops, sometimes you can roll it to the end and it doesn't build up too much, or sometimes it gets too big and you have to take it off, cut the bag, hook it back on, or cut it, or do what you have to do. But you just figure it out, sort of a situation by situation basis, what decision you make. But generally they're all pretty well the same. If you've got it going well, it works well. All right, let it go.